beauty finders, it's Matthias Allen, otherwise known as Matthias for Makeup on all social media. So I'm so excited to bring you this behind the scenes sneak peek into a gorgeous beauty photo shoot that I recently did here in Hollywood, California. Now for those of you guys who are loyal subscribers, you might have seen my Monday makeup chat where I sat down with internationally acclaimed beauty photographer Kate Setmari, and she and I discussed how to break into the business and work as a successful beauty makeup artist. So please, please, please go check out that video. That is our one-on-one interview only here live on my weekly series, Monday Makeup Chat. I'll put a link down below, or you can click up right here and I'll link it right now if you want to go jump onto it. But please stay with me because I'm going to show you some behind the scenes footage of that actual photo shoot that I worked with her on. The images were gorgeous, and I'm going to go over some great tips and techniques for working as a beauty makeup artist in this vlog. All right, I hope you guys enjoy and stay to the very end.
So working as a pro makeup artist, you really have to know how to concise your entire kit. You can't bring every single thing you own. So I worked with the photographer on the phone to plan out the shoot, exactly how many looks I was doing, which will be four, and I packed very lightly. Now, first thing I'm doing is I'm grooming my model's brows. I'm just taking a few of the extras away before I get into her skin. So I'm gonna start with the Peter Thomas Roth Oilless Oil. This is a gorgeous primer. It's not like a serum that sinks into the skin. It's almost like a primer. So I'm putting this on first. Next, I'm gonna go in with the Veil Complexion Fix, and I'm putting this on her eyelids. This is a very, very light sheer concealer. I'm using this as a base. Next, I'm gonna go in with the Glow Minerals Cream Stay Shadow Stick. Now, these are a waterproof formula. I love these. I just got these this summer, and I just absolutely think they work great as an eyeshadow base. I am blending them out with an eyeshadow brush. Before I move into eyeshadow, I'm using one of my brand new Viseart Petite Palette Pros, and I'm putting this really beautiful pinky gold on her lid. This is going to be the only thing I'm using other than mascara before I do the first look, because this is a fashion beauty photo shoot, so not a lot of product is really necessary. Now, the Water Blend Foundation from Makeup Forever is a fantastic foundation. It is so sheer. It is buildable if you want more coverage, but it really mimics the look of skin. It gives you just such a soft focus feature. It makes your skin look gorgeous and glowing, and I think using the Veil Complexion Fix for face and eyes is going to be my next step. I'm gonna just give a little bit more hydration and a little bit more coverage around the eye area. I'm also gonna go into the T-zone and use this in the middle of the forehead across her little smile lines and down a little bit on the chin as well. I'm blending that in with a damp beauty sponge. Now at this point, when you're working with a beauty photographer who is very established and very talented, you want to make sure that you're on the right track. So you want to let her see the model and give you any idea or clarification as to where to go next. So next I'm taking the Viseart Cream Multitasking Palette for cheeks and lips, and I'm using one of my favorite shades. This is a wax-based formula. It stays on really well. And then I'm also using the Viseart Muse Nudes Palette, and I'm going to just do a simple cream lipstick gloss on the lip. Next, I am on set, and we saw that in the first couple shots that her body was just a little bit deeper and tanner than her face. And that happens quite often because models will wear SPF on their face but not on their bodies. So I used the Makeup Forever Aqua Blend to give her a little bit of a lighter coverage on her chest so that the photos would look seamless. Kate, the photographer, and I worked extremely well together. I think we had a great time shooting. The model was gorgeous and beautiful and knew all her angles very, very, very well. There was no need to really give her any kind of advice. She was just stunning and gorgeous. And here is the final look. Now, when you're going in to do a look number two and you're working on a photo shoot, you do not want to completely take off everything that they have already. You need to learn how to build. So what I'm using is I'm using another one of those cream shadow sticks in two different colors, and I'm building on top of the first look. And then I'm taking a deeper lip liner and this amazing matte lip paint from Pure Cosmetics to give her a deeper fall inspired look. The eyes are just slightly different, but the lip is the focus. focus. So you really need to do these changes within like 15 minutes tops before you go into the next look. If you're going to get as many looks out of a 4-hour shoot as possible, the model again was superb. I thought her face and her skin was looking just impeccable on camera, and here is the final look. Now we're about 90 minutes in, and because I've laid so little product on her face, there is no need for really additional fixing. I'm using the Anastasia contour stick, and I'm pumping up the contours of her face and reshaping her hairline as well. I really wanted this look to be a little bit more sculpted and work with the light from the photographer. I also wanted her skin to shine, so I'm using this really beautiful, brilliant shimmer cream from Sigma, and I'm using this awesome brush to apply it. And the reason I'm using a brush to apply it is because if you use your fingers, it's gonna go on very, very thick and heavy, and using the fibers of a synthetic brush like this is going to make it look more sheer. Now I'm taking the Black Track Pro Longwear Fluid Line from MAC, which is a deep black gel liner. This is one of my favorites. I've had it in my kit for probably 15 years, and I'm just creating a beautiful soft cat eyeliner, and then I'm taking a really muted nude peachy matte lip paint from Pure Cosmetics before we get her into the next look. Now I'm looking at the shots and I'm thinking I don't really like the hair, and it's important when you are part of a team to have an opinion and to give ideas to the hairstylist, and this is what we came up with, kind of pulling the hair back. Kate was totally happy with my suggestion, and this is the final look. Do you see how the sculpting really worked to enhance her features? I love this shot. Okay, so next, after about 3 looks, I need to rehydrate her skin, and I love this IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Pores. It is a primer, but it's also a serum, so I'm putting this on top of everything else that has already been applied to rehydrate her skin. And then I'm going in with 2 different shades of the Water Blend Foundation from Makeup Forever because I want to make this look more of a summer-inspired look, so I'm gonna actually tan up her face. So if you look carefully, you can actually see the foundation is deeper than what I've previously applied, and I want her skin to glow, so I'm taking this Giorgio Armani Fluid Sheer and I'm mixing this on my palette and applying it with a brush over the entire surface of her face and then bringing it down onto her neck as well. So this is an amazing product. There are many like it, but this was one of the originals. I believe it has a silicone blend, so it looks amazing and impeccable on the skin. Next thing I'm gonna do is do a little bit more eyeshadow work. I'm using another Viseart Petite Pro palette. I'm using this Soft Taupe, and I'm putting this all over the lid to cover up the previous colors that we've used, and then I'm taking a eyelash curler to revamp out her eyes, a little bit more mascara, a little bit of concealer to reapply under the eyes to give her a little bit more of an impeccable finish. Then I'm taking a really soft peachy pink lip gloss from Pure Minerals because I've done so many matte lips for this look already. I wanted something more glossy, and I wanted her eyes to shine even more, so I'm taking this incredible brand new Makeup Forever Liquid Star Powder, which is gorge. Oh my gosh, it's like nothing else. And this look, we decided to give her a little bit more of a summer-inspired twist in the hair, and the shots that you're about to see are so amazing. I can't wait to hear your comments and thoughts down below. This is what it looks like on the monitor. If you guys are a pro makeup artist out there and you've worked on photo shoots like this, please do leave me comments down below. Let me know what you thought of the final look, because I loved it.
I hope you guys enjoyed that sneak peek of what it's like to work on a beauty photo shoot here on my channel, Find the Beauty. I'd love to hear your comments and thoughts. Please be interactive on my channel, so click thumbs up if you enjoyed this type of video. Also, leave me a comment down below if you enjoy seeing the process of actually working with fashion models and celebrities. You know, I am one of the only pro makeup artist who actually does vlogs from actual working jobs and with clients. So if you enjoy that type of content, please do let me know down below. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already by clicking on that link right over here. I do 2, sometimes 3 brand new videos every single week. I actually have my entire calendar already planned out for the next 3 months. I have some great, exciting content, some giveaways planned. So I would love for you to subscribe to my channel. Please do follow me on all social media. media at Matthias for Makeup on Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, Pinterest, and on my Facebook fan page, where every single week I go live at 5 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on Wednesdays. Did I already say that? I'm not sure. Anyway, I hope you guys stay with me. Click on one of these other two videos that I take you behind the scenes with me on, and I love you for watching. All right, bye, you guys.